Since the year 2020, we have experienced an overload of virtual meetings that has led to the term Zoom fatigue that has been coined in the second half of 2020. But it's not just Zoom. We do know that most video chat platforms, they have design flaws that exhaust the human mind and body. But there are easy ways to mitigate their effects. What is happening? There are four reasons that Stanford researchers found out last year that are supporting virtual fatigue. Number one is excessive amounts of close-up eye contact that is highly intensive for us. So both the amount of eye contact we engage in on video chats, as well as the size of the faces on screens, is unnatural. Imagine, in a normal meeting, people will variously be looking at the speaker, taking notes, looking elsewhere. But if we're in a video call, everyone is looking at everyone, and that all the time. A listener is treated non-verbally like a speaker. So even if you don't speak once in a meeting, you're still looking at faces staring at you. So the amount of eye contact is dramatically increased. And this is a so-called social anxiety of public speaking is one of the biggest phobias that exists in our population. So when you're standing up there and everybody's staring at you, that's a stressful experience. That also means that in video calls, our stress levels are higher. Another source of stress is that, depending on your monitor size and whether you're using an external monitor, faces on video conferencing calls can appear too large for comfort. When someone's face is that close to ours in real life, our brains interpret it as an intense situation that is either going to lead to mating or to conflict. So there is one solution. Until platforms don't change their interface, we would recommend taking Zoom out of the full screen option and reducing the size of the video relative to the monitor to minimize face size, and to use also an external keyboard so that you allow yourself to get an increase in the personal space between oneself and the grid.